Hello friends, a very warm welcome to all of you. So today we are going to discuss another case study, which is a part of our series on issues in GST refunds. And this particular case study is pertaining to the aspects of inverted duty structure for fabric specifically and issues regarding the refunds related to the said industry. So before we go into the details of provisions, let us first try to understand what are the case facts. So XYZ Limited is into manufacturing and selling of fabrics where the rate of inputs is higher than the rate of output supply and thereby covered by inverted duty structure model. XYZ Limited has had made an application for refund for August 2018 to December 2018 on 12th June 2020. Total refund was applied for rupees 50 lakhs along with necessary documents and statements. The refund processing officer has noticed certain discrepancies and therefore on 4th August 2020 issued a show cause notice in form RFD 08 by stating that the refund is not admissible and directed to show cause as to why application should not be rejected on the reason. Taxpayer has reversed the accumulated ITC as per notification 20 by 2018, but not paid interest on reversal of accumulation of ITC. As per para 57.3 of circular 125-44-19 dated 18-11-19 issued by CBIC, refund shall be granted only reversal of amount along with the interest. XYZ Limited had reversed the ITC as required under notification 20-18. As on 11th June 2020, but it has reversed at a date later than the due date of GST R3B of 2018 August. The refund for the period of August 2018 to December 18 is rejected further on the ground that the assessee has not paid the interest on the period of delay in reversal as required by circular 125. Now XYZ Limited has submitted a reply to show cause notice why later so and so along with copies of relevant statements, etc., being eligible claim under section 54.3. However, the learned officer, without appreciating the facts of the case, passed refund rejection order on 18th August in form RFD 06 and held that refund on ITC accumulated due to inverted duty structure is not admissible for the reason which was mentioned in the show cause notice above, that the ITC was reversed but without interest, which is not as per circular 125, para 57.3. And hence, being aggrieved by the impugned order, the taxpayer has filed appeal with the appellate authority. So we need to discuss the merits of this particular case in the appellate stage. So let us try to understand this entire concept first. Because inverted duty structure related to fabrics manufacturing has been the talk of the town since a long time, since the inception of GST. So basically, the manufacturer of the fabrics is covered by the inverted duty structure. And this word inverted duty structure is not defined in the act anywhere. But in Rule 89.5, the term inverted duty structure is used to indicate the tax structure, which is referred in Section 54.3.2, which says where the credit has accumulated on account of rate of the tax on inputs being higher than the rate of tax on output supplies, other than the nil rated or fully exempt supplies, except supplies of goods or services or both, as may be notified by the government on the recommendation of the council. So government here, what is inverted duty structure is referred to in Section 54.3. And that is being the rate of tax of inputs is higher than rate of tax of outputs. But the government can have an exception to this rule. And those powers are there with the government to notify supplies where the refund of ITC is not admissible, even if there is such kind of an accumulation, which is on account of inverted duty structure. So in exercise of these powers with the government, in respect of goods, the central government had issued a notification, that is 5/2017, Central Tax, CTR, dated 28th June 2017, and further amended by a notification 44/2017, dated 14 November 2017, wherein it had notified 10 categories of fabrics in respect of which unutilized ITC will not be admissible as a refund. So they categorically listed out certain commodities or certain manufacturing activities which were kept out of the purview of this refund facility, though there was an inverted duty structure. Further, requests were received from the textile industry to relax the said condition to allow refund of accumulated ITC. So in 28th General GST Council meeting, the request to remove restriction on refund of accumulated ITC was agreed by the GST Council, and this change was made with prospective effect, and a conscious decision was taken by the council that the input tax credit lying in the balance on the date of the notification implementing the new provision shall lapse. This lapsing of accumulated input tax credit was in the spirit of the earlier rate structure, which envisaged that refund of accumulated credit was not to be allowed. The government-wide notification 20/2018 means to give the effect of this discussion and agreement in the GST Council meeting. Based on the recommendation, a notification was passed dated 26 July 2018, which allowed the refund of accumulated input tax credit on account of inverted duty structure on fabrics of those 10 categories of fabrics which were earlier restricted and not available. This allowance of refund became effective from 1st August 2018, because it was prospective, with a condition that the balance accumulated input tax credit lying unutilized up to the month of July 2018 shall lapse. Thus, refund of inverted duty structure is available for the 10 variants of fabrics from 1st August 2018, and hence the ITC on procurements prior to the effective date is to be reversed, as a refund for such credit was not available initially. So the government had clarified that restriction is applicable only for input tax credit of goods, and the said restriction does not become applicable to input tax on input services as per or capital goods. So in the concerned case, if we see, there are three major issues which are involved. One is refund rejection due to non-following of a circular which says interest is payable on the reversal of ITC. If not done, then not done in timely manner, means the reversal is not done with the return of August 2018, then interest needs to be paid. Second, validity of the notification which challenges the vested right of input tax credit by demanding it to reverse the ITC balance at some specific date to which the taxpayer was eligible to claim benefit. And thirdly, validity of the circular itself, which asks to reverse the ITC as per the notification and further with interest when it in the first place it is not utilized. So ITC, though it was not utilized, while reversal, you should do it with the interest. That is the third issue. So if we see, the contention of the government was the power to lapse the input tax credit as per them flows inherently from the power to deny the refund of accumulated input tax credit on account of IDS in section 54.3.2, which we saw in the beginning. Though the process which was applied here was that firstly, the taxpayer, even prior to the date of coming into the force of notification, were not able to take the benefit of this credit as a refund on account of IDS that was blocked. Secondly, in circular 56, wherein all the issues raised by the textile industry dated 24/2018, wherein all the issues raised by the textile industry were clarified after due consultation with the trade. And thirdly, on the whole issue, there was an extensive discussion and deliberation with the trade and industry and other stakeholders, including the level of Union Finance Minister, and all the inputs from all the states' governments were also taken into the consideration before issuance of this circular. But does that mean that circular is legal? That is the question that we will have to look into. The assessee contends, the taxpayer here in this case contends, that the interest is not required as per section 50 sub clause 1. That is amended by way of adding a proviso to the effect that interest shall be payable only on cash component. And the CBIC has also clarified by way of a press release that the amendment is to be applicable from 1st July, even though because of technical reasons, it was notified earlier prospectively. But as declared in GST Council and by CBIC, the amendment is with effect from 1st July 2017. And now that the amendment through Finance Act 2021 is also effective by the notification. Therefore, interest payment of ITC balance, which is unutilized, is not required. And in my opinion also, one important aspect which one needs to understand here is that the condition of lapse of the credit, ITC credit balance as of 31st July 2017 may be ultra vires to the provision of law. To support this, I would like to refer the judgment of Honorable Gujarat High Court in case of Shabnam Petrofields Private Limited versus Union of India, wherein Honorable Gujarat High Court struck down this provision of notification 20 by 2018 in respect of requirement of reversal of ITC as is ex facie invalid and is being without any authority of law. The High Court remarked that the section 54 does not empower the government to require lapsing of ITC, referring some of the landmark decisions in the past, such as Collector of Central Excise Pune versus Daiichi Karkaria 1999, Eicher Motor versus Union of India 1999, etc., where the main contention was that vested right in law can't be done away with the authority of rules or notifications, which is equivalently happening in this particular case that we are discussing. Further, where the order passed by Honorable Gujarat High Court in Shabnam Petrofield striking down lapse of ITC before 31st July 2018 in case of viewers shall be applicable to other states also, because this is a specifically Gujarat High Court decision and it is challenged in the Supreme Court. To answer this question, the decision laid down by Supreme Court in Kusum Ingots and Alloys versus Limited Appeal Civil, dated 28 April 2004, may be considered, which says an order passed on writ petition questioning the constitutionality of a parliamentary act, whether interim or final, keeping in view the provisions contained in clause 2 of article 226 of the Constitution of India, will have effect through the territory of India, subject of course to the applicability of act. Also, Madras High Court held in Dr. T. Rajkumari versus Government of Tamil Nadu that it is tried to say that once a High Court has struck down a provision of Central Act, it cannot be said that it would be selectively applied in other states. Hence, the decision should be applied in all the states, in my opinion. So, assessee though could have contended the same while not reversing the ITC on inputs accumulated as on 31st July 2018. Nevertheless, while filing appeal against the impugned refund rejection order, the assessee should consider all the above facts to support his contention to claim the refund. The assessee has reversed the ITC, but at a later date, that is a day before application of refund, and the assessee in appeal should also highlight that even if interest is payable, the department should sanction the refund subject to the payment of interest, as the circular does not warrant rejection of refund but requires payment of interest on delayed reversal of ITC, which are two different aspects altogether. Also, considering the facts of the case, the refund is admissible without the payment of interest on delayed reversal. The reason is that interest of a delayed reversal is not required by notification 20, but it is contemplated by circular 125. The scope of circular is to clarify any legal position to set out in the act, rules and notifications. A circular does not have force of law. It cannot impose a liability which is not in the first place imposed by the law. Further, even without considering the circular, if we study whether the interest on delayed reversal is required, we find that the stand taken by the taxpayer regarding non-payment of interest on ITC balance is correct. The amendment of section 50 subsection 1 is retrospective after all the saga of whatever interest of whether the interest under section 51 is on gross or net, starting from Telangana High Court decision in case of Mega Engineering till Refex Industries Madras High Court and further series of tweets on the Twitter, press releases and whatnot. We all are aware of the developments that those have gone undergone regarding the said concept. Further, another important aspect to look for here is that notification 20/18 says that ITC as on 31st July 18 shall lapse. It does not specifically mandate the RCC to reverse it. Technically, though I agree that only way to lapse the ITC is to reverse it, but law has not mentioned, or the circular does not mention that specifically. Notification does not mention that specifically. Therefore, even if the provision of lapsing is assumed to be valid, then also such lapsing automatically occurs by virtue of the notification itself and operation of law. Therefore, subsequent reversal by RCC is just a formality in my opinion, and hence the RCC violates the provision of lapse only if he utilizes the balance before reversal. But the RCC has not utilized it, and therefore, since the lapse he has already taken place on 31st July 18, subsequent delayed reversal without utilization would not attract interest in any manner. The reliance can be kept in this matter. Reliance in this matter can be placed on judgment by Honorable Patna High Court, Bihar, in case of Commercial Steel Engineering Corporation versus Bihar, by stating so that had it been a case where credit shown in electronic ledger was availed or utilized for meeting the any tax liability for the year, there would have been no error found in action contained by it would be stretching the term availment beyond prudence to treat it mere reflection of the transitional credit, because the issue was pertaining to transitional credit and the RCC has availed the credit but never utilized it, and still the interest was recovered by the tax officers. Wherein the High Court intervened saying that the terms availment, utilization, though not specifically defined and in the act here in GST, has got a specified meaning, and as the ITC balance is still there, the interest should not be, charging interest would be too much of stretching of imagination by the officers. So the difference between availment and ITC utilization against liability was made clear by the court for charging of interest. So in my opinion, to sum up all these facts, the contention of the RCC regarding ultra vires of the notification 20/18 to the extent of requirement of reversal of ITC vis-a-vis the power given under CGST Act is also appropriate. The decision of Honorable Gujarat High Court should have a guiding value in Maharashtra, as there is no judgment by Bombay High Court on this particular subject. However, this matter is now sub judice at Supreme Court. The appellate authority, that is another technical issue, that appellate authority is not bound by the circulars, but overall there is a belief amongst the authority that they should follow the circulars. But if we apply that logic, then appeal, there is a redundancy in the concept of appeal at the appellate level. So therefore, it can sanction the refund by treating the circular as inconsistent with the provisions of the act and the notification. And so that was it on the case of inverted duty structure regarding fabrics. I hope this case study would have helped you to clarify a lot of concepts pertaining to the inverted duty structure of relating to fabrics industry. And if you like the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to our channel Easy GST for you and share this video with your friends. Thank you so much.